60 years of oppression by the Chinese government have not won the support of the Tibetan people. So it is time for China to reconsider its policies. From outside of Tibet, the message that is coming is clear. We continue to advocate for those who are in prison and for all Tibetans who, until their aspirations will be met. China is a superpower, but it's a superpower which is built on very fragile foundation. The lack of democracy, the lack of rule of law, the lack of transparency are a threat to the world, not only to the Tibetans, to the Uyghurs, to the Hong Kongers, and to the Taiwanese or the Chinese people themselves. The world is finally awakening to the threat posed by the Chinese government, and the pushback has begun. More reciprocity will be asked not only on trade issues, but on access to Tibet, on freedom of movement, on freedom of information. More religious freedom will be asked to stop the total control by the Chinese Communist Party of religious institutions, including the selection of the future Dalai Lama. And this is not going to happen. More transparency will be asked to make sure that the environment in Tibet is protected and that the water resources that are coming from Tibet are fairly shared with the downstream countries. This is a moment in which the people of goodwill across the world have to stand up and demand that China becomes a country run by the rule of law. The lack of transparency has shown the world what dangers can come to China, whether it's the violation of human rights, whether it's global health, whether it's global trade. This is a threat to the entire world. For this, in the next few weeks, we will continue here in Washington, D.C., to mobilize for the fast approval by the U.S. Senate of the Tibetan Policy and Support Act. This legislation strengthens and revamps U.S. policy on Tibet. It imposes restrictions on Chinese officials who interfere on religious freedom and the selection of the next Dalai Lama. It will impose to the Chinese government to allow the opening of a U.S. consulate in Lhasa if the Chinese government wants to open another consulate anywhere in the United States, and it has many other important provisions. We have scheduled our Tibet Lobby Day on the 23rd and 24th of March. We are now reviewing the situation due to the coronavirus infection, but the Tibet Lobby Day will go on, whether online, with phone calls, or in-person meetings. So we call on you to participate in whichever form you can. We have strong bipartisan support in the US Congress, and this is the time to continue our advocacy to make sure that the Chinese government gets the right message and changes its policy on Tibet. Thank you very much. Thank you.